Hello friends, welcome to the Edu Marinos. Friends, we are continuing our session, that is boiler, and this is the part 3 of that boiler. In our last video, we were discussing about types of fire tube boilers, and we have discussed one type of fire tube boiler, that is Scotch boiler. In this video, we will be discussing some more types of fire tube boilers. So let's start our video with one of the type of fire tube boiler, that is Cochrane smoke tube boiler. Cochrane is a typical tank boiler of vertical type, and it is suitable for producing relatively small amount of low pressure steam. Friends, this is a Cochrane smoke tube boiler. Here fuel is burned in the furnace and hot gas is produced, and these hot gases goes to the combustion chamber, and through the smoke tubes this goes to the smoke box and then to the uptake. Friends, here a refractory material is fitted on the combustion chamber, this side of the combustion chamber, and on the floor of the furnace and the side of the furnace to safeguard the boiler seal from overheating. Here the combustion chamber top, this requires support, so gusset stays are provided which transfer the stress from the flat top of the combustion chamber onto the boiler seal. The flat tubes plates are tied together by means of stay tubes which is screwed into the this smoke tube section. Friends, modified form of the Cochrane boiler is now produced in all welded form. The Cochrane boiler can also be adapted for use as an exhaust gas boiler using the exhaust gases from the internal combustion engine for generating steam. In some cases, for use as composite boiler where exhaust gases and fuels can be used, that this composite boiler that we will discuss in our coming videos. And let's see the other type of smoke tube boiler. Friends, now we will discuss Clarkson thimble tube boiler. This type of boiler was developed by Clarkson, and a series of horizontal tapered thimble tubes heated externally without any special means been provided for circulations within the tube. So let's see the diagram. So the basic form of the boiler consists of an outer seal enclosing a cylindrical furnace surmounted by this combustion chamber, into which this thimble tubes are projected. Friends, these thimble tubes which you can see here, these are expanded and bell mounted into a cylindrical tube plating forming the combustion chamber. The upper end of these tube plates is connected by a disc plate to the uptake, which passes through the steam space and is then attached to the dome top of the outer seal. These boilers will operate for long periods without internal cleaning. If an undue amount of scales forms inside the thimble tubes, that is like very difficult to remove. So a reasonable quality of feed water should be provided for this. So friends, this type of boiler which is shown in your screen is oil fired, but other versions can be used as waste heat boilers making use of the hot exhaust gases from internal combustion engines, or designed for composite firing using exhaust gases and oil firing as required. Now next fire tube boiler is spanner vertical smoke tube boiler. So the basic form consists of an outer seal enclosing a cylindrical furnace which is connected by this vertical smoke tubes to a cylindrical smoke box at the top of the this boiler. In this early version of this boiler, a riveted sail encloses welded internals, but in later designs the boiler is of all welded constructions. Friends, the vertical smoke tubes are like a patent design known as swirl flow tubes. They have a special twist along the greater part of their length, only a short portion at each end being left plain to allow for expansion. It is claimed that these swirl flow tubes are more efficient than normal plain smoke tubes, in that they cause the gases pass through to swirl. So, coming in more contact with the tube wall and therefore increasing the rate of heat transfer. Friends, in this boiler, no stays are required for the outer sail and for the internals. Like only the flat tube, for the flat tubes, that these stay tubes are required to support. And this is done by stay tubes of plain sections. Stay tubes of plain sections expanded and then welded into the tube plates. So this type of boiler can also be used as composite boiler. So friends, this was all about our this video. We will be coming with some more videos in this series of boiler. So friends, please go to the comment box, tell us how was the video, and if any doubt related to these topics, then you can ask in the comment box. Link for other videos of boiler is given in the description box. You can just go to the description box and click on the link. Thank you.